Before South Sudan plunged into war, Uganda's export earnings from the country had risen to $3.93 billion. However, it later dropped, the reason why the two countries are now renewing efforts to give a boost to their trade ties. They started with a bilateral meeting in Juba, which brought together officials from the private sector, Minister of Trade, Minister of Foreign Affairs, among others, to review the interest of the two countries in terms of trade.
The meeting reviewed the interest between the two countries in terms of trade, what needs to be done and what has not been done. Particularly, the meeting is a preparatory one for the next meeting that will take place in July, which will be the symposium and the exhibition of the trade between the two countries.
Things that inhibit the growth of investment or the growth of trade between our two countries, Uganda and South Sudan, is a lack of information. So we will start by ensuring that that information is available, that South Sudan is open and it's running a conducive business environment. We are aware that there are over 10,000 registered businesses in this country. We're also aware that there are a number of commercial banks in this country, and we will share this information.
Trade barriers impeding the flow of business among the two countries are to be removed.
Is the best forum where these challenges that the business communities meet is facing, and also to look at the opportunities particularly that they can be able to both of them exploit together for the win-win situation for the people of Uganda and the people of the Republic of South Sudan, so that the two sides can be able to work together to improve the livelihoods of the people of their two countries.
Next month, the two countries will still hold their first joint business forum in Juba to promote commercial and business interests. Relatedly, officials from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs have toured and inspected the Chancery House, which the Ugandan government is building in South Sudan.
First of all, Ugandans consider South Sudan as their second home. There are so many Ugandans here because of the cross-border trade and activities. There are so many Ugandans here, moving in, out. And because we register so many Ugandans on a daily basis here with the consular issues, we feel that getting our own, we can always handle our issues conveniently, and we have enough space now.
The storage building, which is soon nearing completion, will provide consular offices and provide accommodation to the Ugandan staff in Juba.
In Kinshasa and Juba, they are at the same level of construction. And as you can see, before you serve people properly, you must have a proper address. My brother explained to you that they have the consular offices, and I imagine this would be the main consular offices whereby people, Ugandans and non-Ugandans, would come and get the services at the entrance, such that they don't need to go deep inside because the process of entering might be long.
Report by Juliet Namuwaya for the news.